Thanks for every day because it reveals to us his kindness and goodness and wonderful heart. We might take things for granted that we see around us or what happens. At times you might not even see how kind God is through what he does in creation. You know, you can be blinded from the reality, you know, you can be blinded from reality, and you, instead of seeing what is there, you see something else. So we bless the Lord for his kindness every single day. Wake up, you be grateful to him, for there's a purpose for that day. There's a reason why there, and it's always amazing, even wonderful now, for you to know, to be sure of what God has in mind. When you have in your mind what God has in mind, you are blissfully blessed. Now pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ that indeed you will not live a separated life from God. You will live that life of union which has designed for you. It was his dream and he is his dream. May you live the dream of God in your life. In Jesus' mighty name, glory to God forevermore. In 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 18 is where we began to look into. In this verse, we saw something very, very important. It talks about all things, you know, now being of God. He says, and all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ. I was then explaining the meaning of all things belongs or are of God. So I said, after now you are a new creation. If you were a new creation, actually, he talks about you in these words, that now you belong to him. All things are of God. You now, whatever that is, what God knows about you is of God. There's nothing of anybody else he knows about you. You might not have the same, you know, understanding. You might not see exactly what God sees about you. But again, this is the purpose of the gospel, is to help you see what God is seeing about you. Know what God knows about you. See, this is very, very crucial, very important, you know. I want you to understand how urgent this is. You seeing what God sees about you, you knowing what God knows about you, is very, very crucial. The important part here, the things we're looking at, the things which you should realize here, is that this happened because of something very, very powerful that happened. In other words, this is a result of something else. And you know the result? It's a result, you know, it is a result of the reconciliation. God who had reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ. So he's saying that, he's not just saying that, you know, you now, all things about you are of God, and, you know, because he just said it. No, it does not happen because he just said it. He did it. He reconciled us to himself. You know what that means? To be reconciled to God, or this word reconciled us to himself. Oh my God. He reconciled us to himself. He reconciled us to himself. He reconciled us to himself. Do you realize that we didn't do nothing? He just reconciled us to himself. It's like you take something, you know, you pick it from somewhere and you bring it to where you are. You take it by yourself. You make it yours. You make it your possession. And generously, you don't want anybody to come close to it. It is yours. He says he reconciled us to himself. And the meaning of reconciliation here, brothers and sisters, is much more than bringing two things close. It is not bringing us to close to Him. Because the idea of many people about reconciliation is like, okay, people had issues between themselves. And so these two parties that are not in agreement, you know, they would then agree on certain terms or certain things, and then now they can be good neighbors, you know. It's not exactly that. It is much more than that. It is not us brought close to God. You know, we like that word. We even enjoy it so much. We love this word, oh God, bring me close to you, or I come close to you, or being close to God. And oh no, but he's talking about reconciliation here. And the reconciliation is not just about any enmity or separation in terms of course, two people who didn't agree on something and then separated. And so then the reconciliation is that now they don't have any issue together and one is a neighbor of the other, like I said. No, it's much more than that. Because it's talking about you and him becoming one. So there is no you or him. Glory. There is no him and you. That is the level of reconciliation he's talking about. So when he says he has reconciled us, no wonder he says that all things are of God, because he reconciled you to himself. Do you see the difference between him reconciling to you? He's saying he reconciled us to himself. Not God came and reconciled himself to us. No, he reconciled us to himself. There's a difference. He's talking about us somewhere. He picks us. He brings us into his holiness. He brings us into his kingdom. He brings us into his life. He creates space in himself and includes us. So creating that space and includes us, it is very, very powerful. This is different from, you know, we were there and so he came and reconciled himself to us. This is much more. He brings us into himself. And he says he reconciled us. So the idea of reconciliation, like I'm saying, is much more than bringing two parties into agreement. It is making two to become one. My. This is the reconciliation he's talking about. So there's no you and him. There's no him and you. There's that reconciliation. There's that union to the extent that you cannot separate yourself from him, or he cannot separate himself from you. And even the world cannot separate yourself, you from him. For example, let me tell you something. You know, in the Bible, the Jesus Christ came and he said, you know, he's the light of the world. I say, I'm the light of the world. And then later he said, we are the light of the world, right? Now, do you think that he's saying that I am the light of the world and you too, you are the light of the world? No. He says that when I came as the light, I shone upon you, and whatever the light shines upon, it turns into light. So in other words, you became like me, you became me, and I became you. See this kind of reconciliation. And so now today you are the light. But that light you're talking about is about you and I who have been reconciled together, who are one, and so we are shining. Though he's talking about you, but he's not talking about you anymore separated from him, or himself separated from you. He's talking about now you, the light you have become is you and I combined together. In other words, if you were darkness before, like we have that scripture in Ephesians chapter 5, that we were darkness before, right? We were darkness. In other words, we lacked the light, because darkness is the absence of light. So now you were no longer darkness. That is what you used to be. But now you're no longer that. You know why? Because the light has come and the light turned you into light. Have you seen that when the light shines in any dark place, darkness will disappear and that place will become light? Yeah, that place will become light itself. Because the light has power to turn darkness into light. So if we were darkness before, who are we today? We're no longer there. We no longer exist. See? We no longer exist into existence because the light has power to turn darkness into what? Into light. So who are we now? We are the light. But then that light is not you and God, or God and you. These are just words. It's you in Him and Him in you. You see what I mean? There's this, the two have become one. You're not close. You are not close. You are just one. That is why you're called light. You are the light because Christ in you is light. He's not light anymore without you. This is the meaning of reconciliation. The reconciliation he's talking about is much deeper than you coming close to Him. So our prayers and our meditations or our words should change. Instead of talking about us coming close to God, no, we have more than that. See, you can feel good with that word. You feel like, oh, if I'm close to God, it will be enough. Oh God, I want to be close to you. See, these are words we use to other human beings because you see, it is impossible normally for you to become one with a person, physically speaking, and that person penetrates in you and you penetrate in him and you are one in that way. No, you can be good neighbors, you can live in the same house, you can be in the same place, but the best you can be is to be close to that person. You feel like the people you love, you can be close to them. But you see, we are not close to God because God is much more than that. You know, it's possible for Him to penetrate us and we penetrate in Him, and to the extent that we don't see Him close to us, or we see ourselves near Him rather, we see ourselves in Him and He see us in Him. We see ourselves in Him, and also He can see Himself in us. So there's this interpenetration, union that is called close than close. This close that is than close is what He's talking about, this reconciliation. Brothers and sisters, when He talks about you, that whatever now that is of you is of God, everything about is of God. He's not lying because He knows. He has reconciled Himself. He reconciled us to Himself. And that reconciliation is you and He became one being. Glory to God. What a love. What a love. I pray that you get to know these things and you understand it. Shalom, shalom. Jesus, I trust.